Hi guys, so it is a sunny Valentine's Day, so perfect day to continue taking apart the Soviet frequency generator, I think. Let me find the tool I need. Yes, this. So I will remove the side frames from the device. First, there is this upper structural part here. I did shift a little bit here and the screws are already loosened because you never know if you will encounter a stuck screw. Typically Russian screw design here. This one are not bad. Then two more. In fact, I am in a hurry to take this apart because I have a big thing arriving in the mail. So, here we are. Or what it should be. Yes. Maybe, no. Yes. No. It does not want to come up. Really. So I have to remove the frames, the side panel first. And then it will be okay, I think. Adjusting the camera here. Okay. So here we have three screws on the side. And I think this side panel should fall off. Yes. So I have wires to cut. Here you can see what is inside. This is just a plastic part clipped on. Here, potentiometer, you can see nice amber tone body. Bracket here. On the side, I am still stuck with this part. So, a lot of weight is still in this centerpiece. There we are. I may add a wire harness to cut from here. This piece is really annoying. Here we are. Here we are. One more thing here, resistor. And one more thing here. Know what it is, take it. It should come off. One more wire harness here, and here we are. Okay, at least. So, now we have a better view of this unit with a lot of panels, with lots of screws. It will be interesting to see what there is inside. And here is the PCB on the side. You can see the three resistors in metal cans, of course. Some paper oil capacitor. It is quite an unusual way to see how it is mounted here. It is, there is a bracket and it is directly soldered on the PCB. It is not, usually there are wire, these things. You can see wire harness that it just cut. And with some mold over here, more potentiometers in this column, and the annoying part here, here it is, You can see it is a quite rough mold, it seems they used to do it. Because this surface contacts were milled in some kind, some way. No, so on the 3D holes here. Some paint. It is almost the paint, the color of paint you have in ships. Ship equipment. And you can see very, very, very nasty work here. Well, it is not. It does not matter by the way, but. You should not see something like this in Textronics or Hewlett-Packard vintage equipment for sure. Okay, so next videos, maybe detailed view of these parts, or maybe trying to separate this from the front panel, removing the buttons from the front panel first, I think. There are set screws in the rails here on the top that will allow me to remove the front panel plate, I believe. These two rail things will come off and the front panel plate will come off also. So, thanks for watching for now. Bye bye.